Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how to customize rows and cells in a React TreeGrid using templates. I will also show you how to customize a row using the row data bound event and a cell using the query cell info event. I'm sure you've watched my previous video on how to get started with a React TreeGrid. If not, please watch the video using the link given in the card above or from the description below. I begin by opening the existing application where all the necessary TreeGrid modules are configured. Note that the datasource.js file has local JSON data with a task and subtask details and is bound to the datasource property. And the subtask details are configured to the parent records using the child mapping property. I have mapped a few columns from the data source to be displayed in the TreeGrid using the columns directive. Let me run this application now. As you can see, the TreeGrid is rendered with the local JSON data. First, I'll show you the step-by-step process of customizing the look and behavior of a TreeGrid rows using the row template property. In this example, I'm going to show the employee's designation in the employee name column and the address, country and contact number in the employee details column. To customize a TreeGrid row, I include the row template property with a custom rows callback method. In this callback method, I define a simple table with three columns. It is mandatory to use the tr tag as a content of the row template, and the count of columns should be equal to the td tags. Here, I had declared three columns, and so I will add three td tags. In the first column, I'll display the employee ID, accessing it from the props variable, and in the second column, I display the employee's name along with the designation. Here, I define the font size to the name and designation to differentiate between them. In the app.css page, I set border styles for the columns. In the third column, I'll display the image. I access the images from the Syncfusion demo link based on the data source field full name. Then I include the inline styles to align the image element. In the app.css file, I set the height and other styles for the image. I include the inline styles to align the element, and then I show the address, country, and contact number in the same column. As the row is customized, I remove the field property from all the columns. Check here, the TreeGrid row is customized based on the specified template. I can also show this custom template as a detail template. The detail template provides additional information about a TreeGrid row. I specify the fields in the column directive to bind row data as it is a detail template feature. To use the detail template feature, I need to import the detailed row module from the EJ2 React TreeGrid package and inject it into the TreeGrid services. Then I change the row template property to detail template property. In the template, I will add another table to show the detailed row. I will comment out the employee ID and name columns and show only the details about the employee. As you can see, the TreeGrid is rendered with a detailed row. Next, I'll show you how to customize rows using the row data bound event. This event will be triggered every time a request is made to access row information, element, or data. I will comment out the template related codes for better understanding. In this example, I will highlight the rows based on the employee's country. To demonstrate this, I add another column, country, to the TreeGrid. I include the row data bound event and assign the customized row callback method. Here, using the row data, I check whether the country is the UK and highlight the row with a CSS child. I set the background color to light gray. Check this. The TreeGrid rows highlighted based on the employee's country. Finally, I'll show you how to customize a cell using the query cell info event. In this example, I will highlight the cells based on the employee's designation. To demonstrate this, I add another column, namely designation. I include query cell info event and assign the customize cell callback method. Using the column field and cell data, I highlight the cells of the high-ranking employees by setting the CSS style. I set the background color to light blue. As you can see, the designation column cells are highlighted based on the employee's designation. Here is a quick recap of what we have seen so far. I showed you how to customize rows and cells in a React TreeGrid using templates. I also showed you how to customize a row using the row data bound event and a cell using the query cell info event. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you are eligible for a community license, which will provide you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.